The tricky part is if I have an expression like mx plus b, I want to make sure that I parse that as if m and x are together and not x and b are together. And another way to say that is I want to see any expression as if it were this sequence of something plus something else plus something else. These pluses can also be minus signs, but anything with the time sign, I want to have that all be within the dot 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 rather than encompassing a plus sign in it. And so what I want to do is write a grammar that defines the language of these expressions. So a grammar is a description, it's finite in length and it should be easy to write. And a language is a set of all possible strings that that grammar describes. And I want to be able to say that in a concise language. Maybe something like saying, I'm going to define expressions, and I want to define the expression as something that looks like this, and I need a name for the dot, dot, dots, so let's call that a term. So an expression can be a term, a minus or a plus, and let's use sort of regular expression notation to describe a plus or minus. And then more terms, but I can just say recursively that that's an expression, and that will give me any number of terms with plus and minuses in between them. So that's one possibility, but that's recursive, and I need a base case, so I can say it can also be the case that an expression can consist of a single term. A plus B is an expression, A plus B plus C is an expression, and also just A. That's the rule for expression, and then I would write the rule for term. It would be similar, it would take into account the multiply and divide, and I would write the rest of the grammar in this format. And notice here I've just sort of made up, I've used wishful thinking to say, I wish I had a notation like this to describe what the grammar is.